Now, for real dynamic behavior, where you're flying through the air as animals do, you want to have a gait like this one. This is a running trot. And to do that, we have springs built into the legs. And some of the energy is recycled from step to step on each cycle and returned. And that's why we call it, one of the reasons we call it a dynamic system. Here's a robot that's on a very slippery surface. This surface is so slippery that we had a very hard time getting up that hill as humans. And I think this is a case where the stability and traction of the robot really rivaled that of a human being. That previous robot's called Big Dog. This one is called Bigger Dog. That's actually not its name, but it is a bigger dog. It weighs about 800 pounds and can carry about 400 pounds of payload. That's a very good fraction of its weight. And it's got really remarkable mobility, all dynamically provided by having an onboard computer. And this robot does another trick, which is it doesn't have to have a driver. So it's using a sensory system, which you see on the front there. You might call it the head. And it's got cameras and laser range finders. And it's watching the leader and going wherever the leader goes. In this case, the leader's cooperative. So it's just following him, weaving in and out of the trees as he goes along. Eventually, we hope to get this to follow at about 30 meters and at full, at whatever speed a human can go. Now, Bigger Dog is really a lot harder to knock over than Big Dog was. And you saw us kind of demonstrating it there. We're working on having it be able to go on all kinds of obstacles. And if it does fall over, this robot was designed so it can get itself back up and keep chugging. So with that recovery capability, it's really got a shot at being able to go out in the world and fail sometime, but then recover and go again. Now here's a cheetah. And one of the things I wanted you to see is that one of the ways a cheetah runs fast is by using its back to articulate the legs. So the range of motion on the front legs and the back legs is much larger than it would be if the back were rigid. So here's an experimental robot cheetah that we built where it has an articulated back and it has legs that don't have quite the range of motion of the actual cheetah. Now, this cheetah doesn't run nearly as fast as a real cheetah, but it runs faster than the fastest human. So this summer, we beat Usain Bolt's fastest running speed, which is about 27.8 miles per hour, and we've gotten the cheetah up to 30 miles an hour. You saw it at the very end there, just before its hydraulics let loose.